What we're dealing with is a multi-million dollar industry, the record business, based on a very unpredictable product, the hit record.
Ain't you ought to get wise. People don't like this sweet singing anymore. They want this rock and rhyme.
This one's brand new, hasn't even been released yet. It's number one on the charts this week.
The planet is screaming for change, Morrison. We gotta make the mix.
Hey, would you like to play the guitar? There you go, well on that.
Hey, this is not a test. This is rock and roll.
You were on TV?
Yes, the Rock and Roll Talent Search. We were the state finalists from Rhode Island.
Ooh. We could be bigger than Lennon McCartney.
We've got two visionaries in the band. You know, David and Nigel are both like poets, you know, like Shelley or Byron, people like that.
Let's rock this joint!
Are you ready to rock?
Is the year that they are now planning for sex on the streets in every major city from coast to coast. And get ready for a shock, the music that they're planning to use to crumble the morals of America is this rotten, filthy, dirty, lewd, lascivious junk called rock and roll. It isn't just the lyrics, it's the beat. 400 teenage girls in Detroit interviewed as to why they had illegitimate babies. They said not just the words, the beat.
I love rock and roll. Sing it, I love rock and roll.
Sing it.
We will rock you.
I'm gonna rock your world.
Rock and roll!
We'll rock this town, rock it in time.
Why don't you get a job, you bum?
But you shouldn't have any trouble finding another job, Sugar Booger.
I mean, I'll work. In my spare time, I'll get some extra jobs. And I'll work on the weekends, and on my days off, I'll stay on.
Well, my goodness, they must be millions of want to take this job.
A steady job, a couple extra potatoes, that's all I want.
Well, I'm going to be the first lottery winner ever that talks like I got a brain. You know, the average guy's worked hard all his life, now he wins $35 million. They got him on media news. $35 million, and what does he always say? No, I ain't gonna quit my job. Stupid idiot.
One of the worst disasters of the Labor Day weekend.
Hi, working a double shift for Labor Day. Oh, look, I broke a nail.
Be glad you got an honest job.
Tree.
I've worked in a kitchen. People get, oh boy, it's a whole thing with no patience and foreign accents and a lot of wiping on dirty aprons with cleavers and threatening, you know. I kill you! Pick up! People get very cranky at 125 Fahrenheit. You know, like, pick up! I kill you! Plus, they call you by what your order is. That becomes your name. French toast, pick up! Getting cold. Yeah, French toast. Yeah, you mother French toast. You want to try a French toast, eh? I kick that French toast ass at French toast. Come here. Don't you start a macaroni.
Maybe I could be of some help. Maybe I could swing a little influence and get you a job with me down the sewer.
I don't know anything about this.
How about it, Ralphie boy? Would you like to join us, denizens of the deep?
I told you, Norton, I don't know anything about working in a sewer.
When you pick it up, you just learn like I did. I mean, after all, what did I know about my job before I joined the Department of Sanitation? I didn't even know a sewer from a hole in the ground.
So long as it's being done in some other country where they make my sneakers that cost $100.
I've got the power, and I've got.
Labor Day Sticks with Blue Collar Man. Before that, Creedence Clearwater and Proud Mary. And we started Taking Care of Business with Bachman Turner Overdrive. And it's more labor-intensive rock and roll from Steve Miller, Queen, The Grateful Dead, and Van Morrison. Right after this union break.
Hey, Jerry, pick me up a double latte on the way back.
Never let a stranger in your cab, in your house, or in your heart. Unless he is a friend of labor.
What I do, it's my job.
Yeah, we're taking it easy, letting somebody else do the work on a Labor Day. Hey, you rookie, I think it's time to play another record, and I could use another cold one, too. Thanks a lot, Phillips. You may amount to something yet.
You're going about it the wrong way, if you don't mind me saying so.
I am.
Now, tuck your shirt tail in good. Pull your shoulders back. Jut your jaw out. Come on. Now, you just say, I'd like to apply for a job. That really impressed me. I know right there I was talking to a live wire. Maybe another young Rockefeller. All right, now go by the door and try again.
I'd like to apply for a job.
That's it? That did it, oh. Boy, you really laid that on me.
Thanks, Goober. When do I start?
Start what?
Job.
Well, I ain't got no job for you, Ope. I just showing you how to apply for one.
Big boss, man. Can't you hear me when I call? Boss man, can't you hear me when I call? You ain't so big, you just
Overheard us talking, and he heard me say that I'm an actress.
So naturally, he offered you a job as a shoplifter, right? I got it.
Will you just listen? He's the head of the security force for the store. His main job is to prevent people from taking any merchandise. He wants me to pose as a shoplifter, just to test their alertness.
Try and grab me a set of golf clubs.
Oh, Donald.
Well, honey, what do you do with the stuff after you take it?
We have this secret meeting place where I bring them all the stuff.
Fascinating. How long does this job last?
Till I get caught. The better I am at stealing, the longer I get to keep the job and the extra money.
Well, honey, look, it all sounds a little silly to me, but if you enjoy it and you get paid for it, I guess it's all right. You know, when I was a kid walking through the 5 and 10, I always thought how great it would be when I grew up to be married to a shoplifter.
Pressure pushing down on me, pressing down on you. No man has fallen. So slashed and torn.
Pressure.